budget cuts by multinationals. Commercial property increased, there was an increased demand for high quality office spaces, easily accessible with adequate space to let to developers moving away from the CBD to emerging business nodes such as Upper Hill and Westlands. In industrial property, the first half of 2017 saw logistic parks gaining momentum, responding to the growth and demand for high quality international standard warehousing space with modern high specification facilities and varied occupiers. As far as hotel and tourism, I think we're happy to note that the first half of 2017 saw the opening of various international hospitality chains around Nairobi. So there has been significant growth, and a lot of hotels have also broken ground this year. In terms of policy, we're happy to note that NCA and NEMA fees were scrapped for development, and land title fees were also scrapped off. The government unveiled a building research center in a bid to address the current housing shortage, and the center will bring together both private practitioners and housing sector stakeholders. The NCA made it mandatory for foreign contractors to work with local contractors by ceding at least 30% of their contract sum to locals. The government revived the Unity Roads financing program in August that had been shelved in May 2017. Private contractors will now get financing from banks and will construct and manage roads for